Today we will be unboxing the M1 Mac Mini with 16GB of RAM and 256GB of onboard storage. This unboxing is slightly different since this particular Mac Mini was purchased on Apple's refurbished store. The nice thing about purchasing products from Apple's refurbished store is that it's a great place to get deals. Apple products hardly ever go on sale or get large discounts, so this is the next best thing. Normally, going to the 16GB of RAM would cost $200 over the base price. But going down the refurbished route, the spec bump is only $60 over base for a savings of $140. As a Final Cut Pro video editor, the RAM boost is something that I wanted. The money saved also helped to procure other accessories such as the keyboard and trackpad, or a mouse if you prefer, since the Mac Mini ships without any of these devices. There are those out there that might have some concerns purchasing refurbished items, but Apple refurbs are covered by the same 1-year warranty as brand new products. In fact, the only difference between my refurbished Mac Mini and a factory fresh unit is the box cover. The refurbs lack the box art of the brand new ones and instead have a more simple lid with the words Mac Mini and Apple Certified Refurbished printed on it. Now onto the unboxing itself. The Mac Mini arrived in this brown shipping box, pretty discreet, nothing special about it. It has an easy open pull tab on one side. Inside we find the bright white box of the Mac Mini. Funny that this box doesn't have an easy to pull tab like the shipping box, so I had to break out the box cutter. Time for the grand reveal. If I can get the lid off the box. And there it is, the Mac Mini. As with brand new Apple products, this refurb unit is wrapped just as carefully. The Apple unboxing experience is still present even with their refurbished products. The Mac Mini wording stamped on the bottom of the computer, as we can see here. It's a very minimalist machine. There isn't much to it. Basically an aluminum square with ports on the back. Speaking of ports, the I/O is covered with this black film, which we will remove. On the back of the Mac Mini, from left to right, we have the power button, the power plug, Ethernet port, two Thunderbolt USB 4 ports, the HDMI 2.0 port, and two USB-A ports with the 3.5mm headphone jack below. Upon inspecting the unit, there are no scuffs, scratches, or other blemishes on it at all. Official Apple refurbished products are unlike any other refurbs you will see on the market. Other retailers, their refurbished products might have blemishes and other scuffs, but with Apple certified refurbs, it's basically getting a brand new product with a nice discount. Setting the Mac Mini aside, let's see what else is in the box. Here's the usual minimal documentation that no one ever reads, but it's there. Even as a refurb, Apple didn't skimp out on giving the customer a color-matched Apple logo sticker. There's also a quick start guide, and the power cable. And that's pretty much all the contents in the box. Let's take a moment to admire the design of the Mac Mini. On to the Magic Keyboard. This is Apple's official Bluetooth keyboard that usually ships with their other products such as the iMac. Has a nice feel to type on. There's not much in the way of accessories, just the lightning to USB-A cable and some documentation. Now for the Magic Trackpad 2. I decided to go with the trackpad because the majority of my tasks is related to video editing, and it's the input device I prefer for such tasks. Since the Mac Mini, as well as most new Apple products, do not offer expandable storage post-purchase, storage has to be determined at the time it's been ordered. Ordering more storage through Apple can be an expensive proposition. I went with the base storage configuration of 256GB to be augmented with a 1TB Western Digital WD Blue SN550 NVMe drive placed inside a Sabrent Thunderbolt 3 tool-free enclosure. While the onboard SSD of the Mac Mini is much faster when benchmarked, the combination of the WD drive and the Sabrent enclosure results in speeds of around 1400 to 1600 megabits per second. Pretty snappy for my application. Final Cut exhibits absolutely no lag when using this drive setup. The last accessory is the USB-C to HDMI cable to use with my second monitor. M1 Mac Mini Accessory Summary. The Mac Mini is screenless, so you would need a monitor, and can handle up to two screens. You have to bring your own keyboard, mouse, or trackpad. The storage is expandable via external storage drives. Video out is via HDMI and Thunderbolt, and you can expand the ports using USB hubs. That wraps up the unboxing of the Apple Certified Refurbished Mac Mini. So what are my thoughts? I've used the M1 Mac Mini for about 2 to 3 weeks now when I made this video, and I have been completely impressed by this little machine. It blows away my 2013 15-inch Retina MacBook Pro with an Intel i7 processor. Final Cut exports with the Mac Mini are usually done around half the exported video's runtime length. In the past, getting a 1-to-1 export time was the best case scenario. And all the while, the Mac Mini runs nearly silent. No more 747 takeoff sounds, just like the old Retina MacBook Pro. Final thoughts? The Mac Mini is an excellent value for those prosumer users who utilize creative applications such as Final Cut Pro. The performance per dollar equation is pretty much unmatched at the moment. The Mac Mini becomes an even greater deal if the configuration that you want shows up on the Apple Refurbished store. Probably the only downside of the refurb store is that supplies can be limited for certain configurations. And that's the end of our unboxing and first take review of the Mac Mini with the M1 processor from Apple. All the items featured in this video are available through the links in the description below. Clicking on them helps out the channel, and thanks everyone for watching.